All right, so greetings. As I was just saying, pen and paper might be handy. Tonight is our next Builders Roundtable, and it's February 3rd. And my name is Melissa, and I am a silver leader with Young Living. I started about 3 years ago, and it has been quite the journey. So I'm going to keep my story on that one short for tonight because we do have a heavy topic. But Heather, you have not been with us for a little bit because things have been busy, busy in your life. So quick, tell everybody who you are and what you got going on, and I'm going to make sure that we have the right February promos in front of me.
Okay. Yep. My name is Heather Esty. I'm also a silver. Our team is shooting for gold, too. This is actually the beginning of our third year as a team. I'm the leader I'm lucky to be the leader, to the Awesome Shine team. And I am super excited to be back. We've had a lot of drama going on since Christmas, and we're looking like it's on the good side. And so I'm just happy to be back with Melissa because we make a good team.
We do. I have a lot of fun doing these, so I'm glad that we're trucking on with them.
Yeah.
Okay. So, and what is, I do a search for the February promos for 2016, and it gives me January, it gives me 2014 and 2015.
Hang on.
I'm trying to make sure that we do our promos. I'm feeling really stupid here, guys. I'm so sorry. I had everything else together. I was with it.
Oh, whoops. I just clicked on the wrong thing. Never mind. We're just great leaders tonight, aren't we?
Okay. Oh, here, I got it. I think I got it.
Oh, perfect.
Okay.
Yes.
So, yes, yay. Okay, so, that's not it. That's January.
I have it.
Okay, you read our promos for this month.
You make me laugh. Okay, so at the 190 level, you receive a retail value of $102.31, and it's a 15-milliliter wintergreen, a 5-milliliter patchouli, and you get bonus essential rewards of 15-milliliter copaiba. And I know I said that wrong, copaiba. Goodness sakes. If you're at the 250 level, you get 20 essential rewards points as well as the wintergreen, patchouli, and copaiba. And if you go up to the 300 PV level, then your retail value is $209.48 worth of product. And you get the 15-milliliter wintergreen, the 5-milliliter patchouli, 20 essential rewards points, the exclusive Isle of Oils collection, which includes Joy, Ylang Ylang, and Grapefruit. And also you get the 15-milliliter copaiba. So it's really a rockin'. I really like that. I love oils collection.
Yeah, no kidding. I like that too. We've had several people have asked if that's going to stick around. The other thing that is worth mentioning, all months this month, all of the premium starter kits except for the one with the Rainstone, right, with the Rainstone diffuser, all of them are 10% off. And that's not just for your new sponsors, for the people that you're sponsoring and that are joining. That's also for you as independent distributors. If you want to buy one to have on hand or whatever, you can do that.
Which is a really
for 10%
good
off. Okay, so tonight we're going back to the basics a little bit, all right? If you have never examined the Young Living Compensation Plan, tonight is the night to get a good kickstart. For me, this was truly a huge thing in my understanding of what Young Living is as a network marketing company and really just in getting started in general and jumping for it. So as always, we'll be recording the call, and it will be posted later to both the event page and also our Roundtable Facebook group. So if you had the time to get your hands on the print version of the compensation plan and income disclosure, that's great. But if you didn't, you can always come back and listen to it later a second time with that in hand so you can kind of follow some of the numbers and abbreviations and things. All right. It's going to be a little bit tricky to outline the compensation plan without a visual, but we're sure going to make an effort at it, and we're going to still try and keep it in our regular 30-minute rough timeline, 30, 35 minutes. And then at the end, we'll do about a 15-minute live Q&A that will not be recorded. So first, we are going to point out the income disclosure form because it is a legal requirement to make sure that any time that we talk to others about the income opportunity that they see the income disclosure form. So Heather's all set and ready to present that with all of the excitement that goes with the income disclosure form.
Actually, I really like the income disclosure form. And I
do too.
Yeah, I think it gives you a good picture as a leader of the different dynamics of your team and what you can expect as you build a team. So the first thing that I want to point out is the same thing I'll point out to all my leaders when we go over it. The first thing at the top is the most important. 92% of all your active members are ranked as distributor or just member. And so what that means is as you grow in this business, 92% of your people are not going to want to build a business. They're not. They're going to want to order their oils, enjoy their oils, maybe share it with a couple people like family and friends, but keep those people happy. Keep them using their oils and the value of their oils. Teach them that and the oil products, because they're going to be the ones that are the backbone of your team as you move forward. So pay attention to that one. And then when you do begin to build the business, the next part of the income disclosure talks about how 8%, only 8% of all members are ranked as star or above. So if you are star level, high five, you're in the top 8% of our company. And the further you go ranking up, the smaller that percentage gets. But along with that comes a lot of work, right, Melissa?
Oh, it does.
To rank up. So keep that in mind. It's not an easy thing. It is something that takes dedication to work a step at a time.
But it's definitely worth it.
It is, absolutely. I can remember when I argued with Amanda and said I didn't want to be a team leader and I didn't want to ever hold a class. Yeah, I was silly then. Anyhow, okay, so the only one that we have actually listed right now is the 2014 income disclosure, and that's because our company is not required to post one every year. But the figures are still very accurate. We've had other leaders check in on that. So I'm just going to read you off some of the things that you can look forward to expectation-wise as growing in this business. As a member that is ranking to star, you're looking at putting in about an average of 5 hours a week. Now, that's what the income disclosure says, and I think some people work more, but that's probably the minimum. The average percentage of people who are star out of that 8% is 62% of people. So that shows you right there how as you rank up, it gets into a smaller and smaller percentage of that. Your average monthly income as a star is about $73, and that means your average annual income is about $876. Now, that sounds nice, right? But how many of you would like to move up to senior star, averaging 7 to 10 hours a week? It puts you in the 20% of that little 8%, and your monthly income is $261, and that's if you're building according to the shares, like Amanda teaches with the Diamond Maker. We could talk about that at a different time. But so I don't know about you, but $261 a month in my pocket or to invest towards my business when I first got started was a huge thing. Huge, huge thing. And that means your average annual income is about $3,031.32 a year. At executive, you're averaging 11 to 15 hours a week. You are in now the 12% of that 8% in the company. You're monthly making about $617, which is a pretty good chunk of change, and especially if you love what you do. And your average annual income is $7,400 a year. At Silver, you're working 17 to 20 hours a week, and your average monthly income is $2,335. Now, as you can see, going from executive to Silver, yes, you're working more hours, you know, 5 to 10 more hours a week, but your income is much larger. And that is because at Silver is when you start growing other leaders. You change from building a large organization around you to helping others build an organization. Wouldn't you say that's a big change that happens right around then, Melissa?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, and not only that, but executive is kind of where you really start to be considered a leader as well.
Yeah, that's kind of where we like to say, if you think of it as scales, you know, it seems like the goal to get to that point is so hard between that star and executive. You're working, working, working. But then you have other leaders pulling alongside you, and that scale begins to even out until you find that everybody's working towards the same goal. And then you begin to mentor other leaders. Okay, so gold, which is what a lot of us, including Melissa and I, are shooting for, you're working about 23 hours a week. You're in 1% of that 8%. And your average monthly income jumps from $2,300 to $6,500 a month. Your average annual income is about $78,000. Now, I can remember, I don't know about you, Melissa, when I was first a star and thinking ahead to executive, the thought of making, you know, what silvers make at $2,300 a month seemed impossible, right?
Oh, yeah. Silver was, like, where I set my sights. Gold seems like a no-go.
Yeah, and so I think, you know, don't if you're the personality that you can push and push and push and push and push and you can shoot for the stars and think that way. But otherwise, set your sights on where you want to go and don't get overwhelmed by the numbers as we continue to go on. A platinum works about 32 hours a week because, again, you're mentoring a lot of leaders. You're in the 0.3% of that 8%. Your average monthly income is over $15,000. And your average annual income is about $188,652. Diamonds work about 45 hours a week, and this is where the peak is as far as hours you work in the week. And you are, again, now in the 0.1% of that 8%. You average about $32,000 a month, and your average annual income is roughly $384,000 a year. And then it goes back down at Crown Diamond and Royal Crown Diamond. You're working about 35 hours a week. And a lot of them say that, you know, it's more of a maintaining your team as it just organically grows. You're in the less than 0.1% of the company. And at Crown Diamond, your income annually is about $687,000 a year. For Royal Crown Diamond, your income is over $1 million a year. Now, I have heard from a lot of different leaders that the average hours per week seem a little high in the diamond end and a little low in the other end, and that the average monthly income also, that's just kind of a ballpark figure. There are people on either side of that. I would say that for me as an executive, I made more than that. As a silver, it took me a little while to work up to that $2,300, but now we're definitely sitting there monthly. So, and I know quite a few golds who make platinum income. So it really just depends on where your organization is. Did I cover that? Is that good, Melissa?
That is perfect. Absolutely. Okay. Honestly, who couldn't use a little? I mean, by the time you hit silver, you're talking about more than your mortgage payment for most people. You're talking about, you know, executive, you're talking about at least a credit card payment. How many people want to get your credit cards paid off a little faster?
Right.
All right? So just keep these numbers in mind. I actually keep a copy of this disclosure in, I have like a box that I keep certain oils in, and I keep like the four-year career, and it's my kind of travel sharing kit, something I can take with me, keep in my car, because you never know when it's going to come in handy when you're going around town and you're talking to people. You never, ever know. So keep that with you in your kit, okay? Now, to go along with that, we're going to talk about the details of the compensation plan. Like I said, we're going to talk really fast, and you're probably going to have to go back to the to the recording a couple times. The compensation plan, when you look at it, you're going to see it's divided into three stages, okay? Young Living has really tried to lay it out for us so that we can build to Royal Crown Diamond in a very strong, cohesive way if you kind of follow the plan, okay, if you follow the package here. So first, there's creating a foundation, and this is really the part we're going to focus on tonight because it really is the basics of your foundation for your business, especially if you're also keeping an eye on who might fit into the Rising Star bonus. And I'm only mentioning it because it really does, it helps, and it will help your check, and it will help you grow, but it's really not something we're going to have time to dive into tonight. So we can explain that later in other fashions, and I have a recorded link for it too. So we may or may not have time for that. But the second section is building a business, which is then followed by becoming a leader. So that goes building a business and becoming a leader is where you go from silver all the way up to Royal Crown Diamond, and those get into other aspects and other layers that our newer builders are really not ready for. So that's why we're not going past creating a foundation. So creating a foundation is going to lead us from signing up as a wholesale member and distributor from your very first day there all the way up through executive. And there are some abbreviations that we really have to cover first, or you're going to have trouble following our chart tonight. and following our discussion. So this is where that paper and pen might be useful if you have any on hand. So here's our quick run through. We have PV, that means points value. That is, as you likely know, each YL product, each Young Living product has a dollar amount as well as a point value. So whenever you talk about numbers within the compensation plan or promotional items or something like that, they're talking about point value and or combined point value. They're not talking about dollar amounts, okay? So when it says 50 PV or 100 PV, they're talking about 50 or 100 PV point value and not $50 or $100 necessarily. It's often one for one, but it's not always. Do you have something, Heather?
No, I said that's absolutely right. Okay. I didn't realize that in the beginning.
Yeah, I didn't either. So it's a lot of people don't. So if you have to jump in over me, feel free if I miss something or misspeak. Okay, so OGV, organizational group volume, that is everything that you order, all of your PV, plus everything that your team members order in the month, okay? OGV is organizational group volume, and that's most of our focus tonight. A leg, now if you think of your Young Living team like a family tree that it is, you're going to know that a leg then is one branch of the tree, okay? And as you move across the chart, you're going to see the ranks, distributor, star, senior star, executive, and it goes on up from there. Everybody starts a distributor. When you reach 500 OGV, whether through your own purchase, like you can purchase 500 bucks worth of stuff or 500 PV worth of stuff, and you'll be counted as a star, okay? But it's ideal that you achieve that through signing up new members and sponsoring new people to start their journey and become a star that way, all right? So it's a great first goal because if you achieve star by helping new people and then helping them see the value of essential rewards, then you're going to be earning very close to that 100 a month, which is what you're going to need because, sorry, I lost my place on my notes. Every business has operating costs. Ours is no exception. So if Sally is your first sign up, all right, you're going to automatically get $50 for signing her up. That's called the Fast Start Bonus. And, it's two combined things, but basically it's $50 for each person that signs up, okay? And she has to purchase the Premium Starter Kit. Now, to get that check, Young Living requires that you yourself be committed enough to make a 50 PV purchase of your own, all right? So you can continue to spend only 50 PV a month for Sally's first 3 months of membership, but after that, in order to get a check for sharing, you have to make a combined purchase of 100 PV after that third month, all right? And there's three reasons I can think of for this, and Heather, you might have more to offer. The first is if you're not replacing your oils regularly, it means you're not really using them, and it means you're not going to be a very supportive mentor because you're not going to have stories of your own to share. All right, the second is what you do, your team is more likely to do. So if you really emphasize from the very start that these products are worth every penny, then that's what you're going to cultivate. And the third is that they give you 3 months because within 3 months, that's really plenty of time to get to star if you're working at it and to decide if you want to continue to pursue kind of the business angle of Young Living. And so, and that'll get you to a point where you should be making that 100 a month, that goal that we talked about, so that you can continue to roll over. So basically, you'll be earning a check that will repay that $100 operating expense.
Right.
Hopefully that makes sense what I just said.
It does. Can I add something really quick?
Oh, please do.
Okay, I think this is where a lot of people get stuck when they're business builders, because they think, well, if I just sign people up, then I get a quick check, and then they kind of drop the ball when it comes to the mentoring part and the long-term benefit of this bonus and this the reason it's for 3 months. And then also I think people don't realize that it really helps your business to roll those paychecks into building your business versus just pocketing the money.
Yes, absolutely.
I wanted to point that out.
Yes, you want to use a lot of those first checks to put back into helping other people see, again, the value of what you have, because you know it's valuable. We know it's valuable. We're going to help you as leaders that have been there and done that before, we're going to do classes like these, and we're going to do the other classes that you see. But you have to help us get them there. We can't. They trust you as sponsors and as their personal friends more than they're going to trust me as an unknown face, at least for a little while, right?
Exactly.
So you have to help us get them there by inviting and making sure that they're aware that they're there and that sort of thing. All right. So for those people that you personally sponsor, you are going to receive an 8% commission on the PV of any purchase that they make in a month. Okay. And on your creating a foundation compensation plan graphic there, you're going to see that reflected where it says level one, level two, level three. So level one is the people that you personally sponsor. And that's where it says 8%. Now these folks are your first level, and they are what are going to become your leg leaders. So if they decide to share and sponsor other people too, they're your leg leaders, so that when you get to executive, those are the people that you're going to rely on to help build your team up from there. All right. Now, when those members in your first level make purchases, you're going to get that 8% commission. When their sponsorees, when the people that are just below them in your second level make purchases, you're going to get a 5% commission. I chose some details here. So you can kind of follow along and see how that goes through senior star and into executive. Now, executive gets a little bit tricky because as a senior star, just like with star, you can spend $2,000 and be considered a senior star, but that's not ideal. You want to be building from the bottom up. You want to be helping other people to sponsor new people, because to achieve executive, you have to have the help of your team and the support of the people that have been building with you. You have to have two leg leaders that each have 1,000 OGV in their own groups, okay? All right, let's check our time here. Oh, good. We have a couple minutes left. We're pretty close to getting to that 30 minutes, and then we'll move on to our Q&A. But there are a couple of other things that I want to put out there before we go. First is every time that I've increased rank, and Heather kind of touched on this with the income disclosure, but every single time that I have increased in rank, hopefully you guys are still on here, because Heather, can you still hear me? Oh,
yeah,
good.
I
okay.
Can hear you.
All right, because the thing kind of fell.
Recording has started.
Okay, sorry about that. The thing flashed off my screen, so hopefully everybody else can still hear us too. Okay, so every time I've increased rank, I've almost doubled my check the next month. So that's right. One of the things that you can see on that income disclosure, and you're helping others to achieve that as well when you help them, when you work with them and build from the bottom up. So that's where the Rising Star shares come into play. That, again, I have a link to that I'll put in the notes for this call, but we're not going to talk about it tonight as much. Now, if you have sponsored members, and this is really important to know, if you have people in your first level and you've sponsored them and you choose not to make a purchase of 100 PV of your own that month, or 50 if it's in the first 3 months of your first sign-up, then that commission, that 8% commission, is going to go past you, and it's going to roll up to the next sponsor above you who made a 100 PV purchase. And it does not matter if that person is one level above you or 28 levels above you,
right.
That commission is going to roll up. So what does this mean for you? Basically, it means to first make sure your PV is more than 100, and that's combined. So if you want to make 10 orders of 10 PV in a month, then that's going to come up to 100 PV. That's not ideal because you can only make one of those on the central awards, but again, that's a different call. But the other thing is that you want to support the downline of all of your team no matter how big you grow, because sometimes you're going to go 5, 6, 7 levels before you find somebody that's making that 100 PV purchase in a month when you get really big. So you want to make sure that you are supporting all the way down as far as you can and encouraging your leaders to do so as well and to help you with that support. All right? So that is our super, super, super quick compensation plan overview in 30 minutes. We did it.
That's
it's 20, 27 after. And, again, hopefully when my phone, it looked to me like it wasn't recording anymore. So hopefully everybody can still hear us. And I'm going to stop the recording now so that if we have any questions or anything like that, you can go ahead and unmute yourself. And we'll have to learn how to do that at some point. But you can go ahead and unmute yourself and ask away. We'll be here for the next, 10, 15 minutes or until the questions run out.
Okay.